Welcome to part 9 of the PBIS Power Series, Check In and Check Out. Check In, Check Out, or CHECO for short, is one of the more widely used Tier 2 or Tier 3 interventions within a PBIS framework. First, let's define CHECO. Check In or Check Out is a Tier 2 intervention that is designed for students who are not responding to the more universal Tier 1 of expectations being in place, reinforcement systems throughout the school, and teaching of what those expectations and reinforcements are. Check In, Check Out is basically an intervention where a student who is identified as needing some support checks in with an adult in the morning and checks out with that same adult in the afternoon. The positives of these check-in, check-out intervention is that it increases positive adult contact in a school. There are social skills embedded within the intervention. There's a direct link to school-wide behavioral goals and expectations. Frequent feedback is provided for the student. There's communication between the school and the home. And positive reinforcement for the student is contingent on meeting the goals of that day. Many people wonder why checking in with an adult in the morning and checking out with an adult in the afternoon is so effective. Some of the reasons include an improved structure. There are prompts provided throughout the day for correct behavior. Not only does the student check in with that adult in the morning, but the adults that student comes across during the day also know that the student is part of the intervention. We set a student up for success through a CHECO system. Contact is established each morning in a positive manner before school starts, and contact is also established before the start of each period, which is also positive. It helps to create that behavioral momentum throughout the day. Also, there's lots of feedback. We all need feedback to adjust our behavior and make necessary changes. With a CHECO system in place, feedback occurs more often, and it's directed towards a student who needs specific feedback and is identified as needing a more intensive intervention. CHECO is also research-based and has been shown to decrease inappropriate behavior. Checking in with an adult in the morning can occur in any location of the school. Cafeteria workers, custodial staff, support staff in the front office are all encouraged to be members of a CHECO system and a support for a student. When the student comes to school, that student can check in with a teacher or a member of the support staff and review their daily goals. If a student meets those goals, they receive a recognition or a positive reinforcer, and the behavior that we discuss when a student checks in the morning is linked to academic support and outcomes. There's frequent communication between home and school. This communication occurs on a daily basis, and the program is organized so it develops self-management skills for the student. Eventually, we want to be able to remove the CHECO intervention and promote self-management among the student. In order to set up a CHECO intervention, faculty and staff commitment must be obtained. First, we need to talk about whether or not the behavior in question is a major concern. Are staff willing to commit about 5 minutes a day to addressing that behavior in question, and is CHECO a reasonable option? From a school perspective, the school should have a CHECO team with a team leader available, someone to coordinate morning and afternoon checking in and checking out, and a team meeting on a regular basis to determine whether or not needs are being met. Before setting up our CHECO system, we should also have our PBIS system in place for the school. Expectations for the student should be tied to school-wide expectations, and there should be a system in place to reinforce or recognize positive behavior. Also, we should be using data to identify which students may be most appropriate for a check-in and check-out intervention. As mentioned earlier in this presentation, a check-in and check-out system involves the student checking in with a member of the staff at the school in the morning, having their progress monitored throughout the day on daily goals, and then checking out at the end of the day. If the student reaches their daily goals, there should be a training menu or a method of reinforcement in place for the student. We also want to be able to collect data on whether or not the intervention is working. We can do this through the daily updates on the report cards, and we should review that data weekly or biweekly as a team. The diagram on this slide shows the layout of a check-in, check-out implementation cycle. Basically, a student is recommended for CHECO, and CHECO is then implemented. In the morning, that student checks in with their adult contact. If this is a third grade student, they don't necessarily need to check in with their third grade teacher. They could check in with a first grade teacher, a fifth grade teacher, a front office employee, a cafeteria employee, or an administrator. During that check-in, they create goals for the day, and throughout the day, regular feedback is given to the student. This feedback is given through a daily report card. In the afternoon, that student then checks out with the same teacher or staff member they met with in the morning. The report card usually has space for parent feedback and a parent signature. This lets us know that the parent reviewed their daily report card and was able to give feedback to their child. In the morning, the cycle repeats itself. Off to the right of this slide, you see the process from a school perspective. There should be a CHECO coordinator summarizing data for decision making, and then biweekly CHECO meetings to assess student progress. If the program needs to be revised, a team should revise that program for the student, or if the student has shown that they can be successful over time, the student can then exit the program. This slide is an example of the home report card. You see that it's laid out very simply. There's a space for the student's name, the date, and whether or not the student met their goal that day. They also identify one thing they did really well and something that they want to work on for tomorrow. A section is also available for the staff member to make comments that can be sent home to the parent. Parent or guardian signature is requested so that when it comes back in the morning, we know that that parent or guardian has reviewed the report card. This is an example of a check-in, check-out point sheet. This would be a point sheet that follows the student around during the day and is rated during the various subjects that they go to. You can see on the left side of the slide that the behaviors targeted are aligned to the school's acronym, being safe, being responsible, and being respectful. If they score a 2 in one area, they did a great job. A 1 is so-so, and a 0 is not meeting the goal. At the end of the day, the points are added up and a percentage is calculated to determine whether or not that daily goal was met. A daily goal might be 80% one day and 85% a next day, and it may change or be revised according to the student's success. This concludes our PBIS Power Series and the check-in, check-out presentation. If you have any more questions about how to implement check-in, check-out, or any aspect of PBIS, please contact your school psychologist or BIT.